is in the building. It's Power 105.1. Brooklyn is in the building.
What's up? Brooklyn is here today.
Hello.
Okay, we here. What's up? What's going on?
You know, I don't have a lot of artists from Brooklyn that I get to interview anymore. It's only but a few of us from Brooklyn.
That's a lot of us.
There's a lot of people in Brooklyn, but there's not as many as there used to be.
Yeah, you're right.
Should be more, no?
I mean, we coming, though. It's a lot of... We coming.
Okay, tell me who. Let's have a little Brooklyn rundown.
We got Young & May, Designer.
Love Young & May.
We got Cass. Yes. We got Tekashi. We got...
That's true. There is a little
stack. It's wild. It's wild.
But they're already happening. And what's new that we should... What's coming behind?
It's a lot of up and coming. I mean, but we still up and coming too. You know what I'm saying? So it's like.
Do you still feel like that?
Yes, I do. I do feel that way. I still feel like people are still trying to figure me out. You know what I'm saying? And
yeah.
I just feel like this year we're gonna answer a lot of questions.
Tell us some stuff. We're gonna get to know you today,
which is good.
Yeah, actually, just a little while ago, maybe an hour ago, this list of the XXL freshmen. So I guess you are still a freshman.
Oh yeah, exactly. Like it's crazy. Yeah.
I
didn't make it last year, so, you know.
You didn't make the cutoff time?
Yeah,
Was the song out already?
Yeah. It was out. I mean, but, you know, things happen again. Like,
Did you feel salty about it?
Not at all, actually.
Okay.
It's just, like, I just know, like, a lot of, you know, in this game, it's a lot of politics, you understand? So sometimes you got to walk in certain circles to make certain lists, you know.
And
Did you do that for this year? Right now we passed that, you know. I love, shout out to XXL though, but I'm not really like focused on being a freshman anymore. Like I'm coming off a Eminem album. You know what I'm saying? Like it's like
he's like, different. I did goal. Joints with Eminem.
Yeah, it's like, so now it's like, all right, cool. You know, we're gonna make a couple of moves. We're gonna go on tour with Eminem. Like this is a lot cooler things this year, you know. So
yeah.
If it happens, it happens. But that's not a focus of mine, you know what I'm saying? Like
it's still nice to be mentioned,
it's nice to be mentioned. I love it. Again, shout out to XXL. I appreciate them for it, but my
you
focus
ain't pressed
is,
either way.
Yeah,
you're,
right
you're
now, I'm,
on
yeah, I'm locked
things.
In on this project right now, and that's all I really care about.
And by the way, some of the people in this category, the girl, Catch Me Outside, girl got nominated.
Yeah, she's going to make the list, I promise you.
You think she's going to make the final list?
Yeah, I promise you.
Really?
Yeah.
Based on what?
I promise you she's going to on that cover.
The you
girl
said the
is
same
a.
Thing.
What
Based
happens
on
is
what?
What happens is a lot of people care about that about her. You understand? Like when she posts, you know, she's getting, we want to say like maybe like 100,000 likes per post. You understand? Like so there's an audience for that, for the music that she makes, and that's what matters. You understand?
Yeah.
Like it's not about, you know, how
Bars.
Much she's on the radio or not. Yeah,
right.
It's all about your celebrity, how popping you are. You understand?
Is that a little sad?
Nah, it's not. I mean, you gotta respect the game. You understand? Like,
I do.
You gotta. What happens is, again, you gotta learn to adapt and just, you know, and make the best of your situation. You understand? You can't really be stuck on what used to work. Nah, you gotta make.
Yeah,
you understand?
No,
you gotta adapt.
I get that. There's no hate for somebody who finds a come up.
Yeah, like, exactly. No hate. Exactly.
No hate at all. But when you're looking at a specific list that's like supposedly like hip hop, this is XXL supposed to be like. I don't know.
But times change. Times change.
You're right.
You know, times change. Times definitely change. And
I mean,
that girl will be on that
list.
She's on that cover. I promise you.
There is a few New Yorkers here.
Yeah.
6ix9ine. 6ix9ine, is he still new though? Why would he be on a freshman?
Because
list?
He just really came on the scene, like, you know, like really like with a blast. But yeah, he's, you know, super definite. You know.
You know him? Are you friends?
Yeah, we're friends.
I don't know. Say
yeah, I'm cool with everybody from Brooklyn. I'm New York, period. But I'm everybody in Brooklyn. We cool.
Fine.
Yeah.
Let's see who else we got. Casanova.
That's my dog.
King Combs.
King, that's my dog too.
That's Puff's son.
That's my dog. Yeah.
I like his little song.
Yeah, you like his song? Yeah, he just, yo, he just like Diddy. Like when I see him, I see Diddy. Like
he's
the same moves,
Diddy.
Everything. I'm like, oh nah, he getting it.
He's baby Diddy. You can see how he was raised.
Yes.
You can see what he
Diddy,
was
Diddy boy.
To when
Diddy
he was
written
raised.
All over him.
Lil Pump was nominated.
Yeah, he got to get it, man. Pump is...
All the littles. Lil Pump, Lil Xan, Lil Wop, Lil Baby.
Uh-huh.
Why you didn't want to be Lil Phresher?
Nah, I ain't little. I'm big, so it's like big Phresher. I'm too big to be low. Like, it wouldn't work for me.
T-Grizzly. All right, well, we'll see. So.
Grizzly? T-Grizzly wasn't a freshman?
That's what it says. He's a freshman this year.
Wow. Okay.
Listen, Phresher, I don't make this list, okay? It's just here.
Yeah. That's crazy. I thought
but anyway, you were on it. It just came out.
Yeah.
I thought that was kind of
cool. That's
cool.
Yeah, that's cool.
So
I appreciate it.
So tell me about what's happening with you,
man.
Oh, man,
right now, man, I'm just excited, man. We, you know, we're going to go on tour with M in June.
That's amazing. I don't. So
Governor's Bowl.
Hold on. Let's take me back for a second.
Governor's Bowl, yeah.
How did this whole Eminem thing happen?
Very unusual, bizarre. Everything, man. Yeah. Again, wildest dream. Again, just so people know, Eminem's my favorite artist. Him and Jay-Z, they share the same spot. Love in my heart, you understand?
Right.
And so when I got the call from Jay, my manager, Paul Rosenberg had reached out to Jay. Like, hey, listen, M wants Phresher on the project. He called me. I'm like,
had you met him?
I didn't meet Eminem.
But it was based on what?
Wait a minute. And that's what that was. We've been heard these talks, right? But I was like, whatever. You know, I heard that Eminem was a big fan because Royce da 5'9 went and jumped on the record,
right?
Like around when it first came out. M heard it. Royce snapped for 3 minutes, first of all.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? M heard it and was like, yo, who's the beat? Who's made this? What's going on? You know? Paul Rosenberg reached out to Jay, like, hey, listen, Eminem wants Phresher on the project. I get the call. He's like, yo,
like,
you might want to sit down. I'm like, there's no way. There's no way. I can't. How and what? He's like, listen to me. They're flying in such and such time. And I'm like, oh, he's serious.
So M flew in.
No, not M. M flew a couple of his guys
Let's
in.
Let's not
you know
get crazy.
Yeah,
okay,
no.
Right.
M didn't fly in. They had a couple of guys. Yeah. So we had the producer, which is D12. His name is Deshaun. Uh-huh. I'm so mad I forgot his name. But D12. It's two D12 members. They flew in. And they flew in 8 hours just to record and fly back out. You understand? It was like for me. So I felt like real special. And then
Was there a FaceTime conversation?
Conversation was ultimate, man. I'm trying to tell M the whole time, like, hey, listen, I'm your biggest fan. I'm ready to do.
Wait, Phresher, you have to take me through this.
Okay,
all
go,
the
go.
Way.
Okay.
So they fly in, they bring you to the studio.
They fly in. Okay.
Somebody
gotcha.
Says to you, M wants to FaceTime?
Yeah, no. What happens is, Tracy, uh-huh. She says, M wants to speak to you. So. I'm like, okay, cool. There it is, right?
There it is.
We get on the phone. He's like, listen, it's just you, right? I'm like, yeah, it's just me, or whatever. You know what I'm saying? So I go on a private. He's like in the studio, like in the booth, like he's recording. So he's like, you hear him. So I'm like, hold on, wait. And we start talking, man. I'm trying to tell him how much of a big fan I am of him, and he's like, nah, listen. But when you, honey, to you, yeah, like, cause I was singing under the lyrics, and I wish it would have been turned up louder, but cool. He was like, yo, why you, oh, you're nasty, you're sick, you didn't have to do that, you know. And we just vibing, and I'm telling him, like, yo, I want to spit like lyrics from like, so you know, like, I'm not like a newbie of this Eminem situation. I'm just doing it cause you know, it just is cliche. No, like,
you want him to know.
I want him to know, so I'm ready to get Marshall Mathers. I was on punishment, and my mom's bought me Marshall Mathers LP. You understand? That's how much of a fan I was, and I was expressing that to him. But he was just going off about how much he just appreciate what I did for the record, and I did exactly what he wanted me to do. What,
good for
what
you.
He want? Yeah. So
and then that could have just been it.
Yeah. Nah, that's amazing. But now we about to really pick up right now.
To be on the tour,
that was OD. Yeah, so
that's crazy.
It's amazing, man. And you know, and then the Governor's Ball, you know what I'm saying, right here in Randall's Island.
Yeah,
that's gonna be dope. You know, and it's a lot more, but you know, we just working out the kinks.
What's he trying to do? Is he trying to like snatch you up?
We don't know.
Like,
we don't know. We don't know. We don't know. You know,
so you've only had that one FaceTime conversation.
Yeah, that's it. That's it with him. Yeah, but we know. Our peoples keep in contact, you know, like we,
right.
You know, Paul,
yeah.
Paul Rosenberg. They talk, him and Jay talk all the time, you know.
What an amazing co-sign to get.
That's some, yeah.
That's amazing. Pretty great, kid.
Amazing. That was like ultimate, man.
So
ultimate.
How many dates on the tour are you doing?
It's 10 days.
Wow.
Yeah.
What's your show like?
I'm an animal. Like, that's what everybody know me for, really. They see, your energy is like through the roof, you understand? Like,
I
might walk
wait.
Around like calm, and then stage come, and the animal come on. They're like, yo, you don't smoke, drink now? I'm like, nah, man, I'm just full of energy, you know, that's what I do.
So you don't smoke, drink?
Nah, none of that.
There's nothing.
Yeah,
that's
I drink
just
occasionally,
all...
but yeah, just all energy. So you know, I come from the athletic field, you know, football, basketball. So you know, this energy is all there all day.
That's dope.
Yeah.
And so Busta came out. With
oh
you
yeah,
at
yeah,
the
yeah.
After
but,
party.
But yeah, it was crazy, man. Basically, Self was bringing everybody out, and Busta had just went in, and then wait a minute, came on, Busta wild out, stopped the music. Hold on, wow. It was crazy. It was
dope.
Yeah,
had
man.
You met him
Busta
before?
Called me on Christmas, so like that's what kind of relationship we got.
What?
Yeah, I was bugging. Busta called me on Christmas. I was like,
did
wow,
you know him, or he called
you
random?
No. We had met, but I didn't. For Busta to call me on Christmas is like, you know, that's amazing. You know?
What does he say on Christmas
it just,
Day?
Just, yo, Merry Christmas, bro. Like, I was like, yo, Merry Christmas
really?
To you, Busta.
I know Busta for 20 years.
Yeah.
He's never called me
on
Christmas.
He called me on Christmas, man. I was like, wow, that's really, you know, Merry Christmas. You know, I was like, Merry Christmas, big bro. Like, you know,
that's
so
amazing.
That was amazing.
Cosigns,
yeah,
man.
Definitely, man.
Well, you have, I mean,
it's the energy, you know what it is? Like, yeah. Like when you meet me, you know, like the vibe is real. Like, it's no fakeness. It's just all cool. You know what I'm saying? I appreciate everybody work and what everybody do. And people get that vibe. Like, yo, he's a cool dude, you know?
Yeah.
And
so somebody who's just getting up on you now, what should they know about your music?
Oh, man, they should know that I can do anything. Like, musically, like, I can do anything on a record, you know? A lot of people know me for the high energy records, but you know, like, I can do anything, like sing on a record, harmonize, whatever I have to do, you know. So
I mean, and how good is the singing?
No, the singing is not immaculate. Like, I'm not Bryson Tiller or like Neo, but
right.
I mean, it's enough to do.
It's
melodic. Yeah,
it's
really
melodic,
exactly. You know. So again, this project, man, I'm very excited. Like,
so did you come in the game wanting to do all that, or you just came in the game like you wanted to?
Oh yeah, I came in the game. Yeah, I want it all. You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, I want it all. You know, when I came in and I said I was going to do music, I just knew that, you know, again, like, I look up to Eminem and Jay, you understand? Mm-hmm. And then you got Wayne right under. Look at what those guys have done for the game. You get what I'm saying? So you can't want to just come in and say, all right, cool, I'm going to do 1-2 records and I'm done.
Yeah.
Nah, you come to, you conquer, you want it all. You get what I'm saying? Like, we going to work for real.
Good for you,
and,
man.
You know, this year, man, like, I'm so excited.
I know you're getting ready to do an album, right?
Yeah, we're about to drop this project,
so
man.
So what does the album sound like?
Oh, man, it sounds like, just think about being on a roller coaster, right?
Mm-hmm. And I hate roller coasters, but I'm not going to, for this purpose, I won't.
Okay, got you. So you're on a roller coaster, and you just have that up and down, that slope. And that, you understand? We're going to take you on a ride, because, you know, it's not fun. Say if you drive at 100 miles per hour, after a while, it doesn't seem like 100 miles per hour. So you want to stop 50, 100, 70, 90, you know? And so the speed is just, it's all over the place, you know? But it's all in one pocket, but it's just, it's so many different ways, you know? Like, it's entitled PH, you know? Because they call me Phresher with a PH. I always say Phresher, so now we entitled PH, you know? Can't wait for them to see the cover. I can't talk about the cover yet, but
Why? It's
OD. Because it's just, like, that's part of the plan, you know, but it's entitled PH, man, and I'm just very excited, man. It's just so me. That cover is so me, you know. When you see it, I'm like, this is what he did.
Is there cameos? Are there cameos?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Eminem?
No.
You didn't go that far?
Not yet. We don't got the M feature yet, but yeah, we got some good. We got Remy. But we got, you know, we got Cardi. We got Famous Dex, we got Critch, we got Derez, we got Filthy Rich, Joey Badass. You know what I'm saying? Like, we got.
I love Joey. What is the date of the album?
The 6th or the 13th, either one. Right now, we just
of April.
Yeah, April.
Oh, so we right here.
Yeah, we right here.
Videos and all that.
Yeah, video. Everything. Everything. We done shot about 4 or 5 videos. Everything is just in the cut,
and we're just about
to release it. Everybody like, yo, where you at? Blah blah. And I'm like, listen, working. Sometimes you got to do things the right way and not how you want to do it. You understand?
Yeah.
Like 2017, I spent so much time learning the business and learning what to do and what not to do. And now I'm going 28. I'm not gonna do the same thing. You understand? It's bigger business now. We got bigger people involved, and now it's time to just, you know, everybody just waiting for me to give them, put it in their hand, and they just gonna run with it. You know what I'm saying? So I'm excited. And
you
it's
are
like,
in FaceTime
seriously,
with Eminem. You don't give a damn about no freshman.
Yeah. Nah. Don't say that, because I love XXL and I appreciate them, but I care about my relationship with XXL more than just getting the cover. You get what I'm saying?
I'd rather them.
So we just met up. I did XXL meeting just to go there and just really talk to the new staff and meet everybody, you know, but it wasn't more or less like, I want the cover. It was more or less like, listen, I want to make sure that we build.
You want to be a career artist.
Yeah, exactly. You know, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, I'm excited, Ange, man. This project is really gonna wake a lot of people up, man.
Really?
Yeah, it's gonna, cause like, I'm like the sleeper. Like, people are like, all right, cool, is he cool enough? Is he really good enough? Is he that? You know, I can sense that, you know. And this project is gonna wake him up, because I wasn't busy last year. I had Right Now with Cardi B.
Mm-hmm.
I had
Wait a Minute.
And then I had Eminem, but the gaps are so, we talking about 6 months gap. You can't just go missing. You have to stay in the people's faces in this day and age, you know? And so this year, we're going to just be super busy, super active, you know, move around more. And I'm just excited, man, because the project is going to be, I'm going to be moving with a purpose. We're just pushing the project. You know what I'm saying? Like, I want to drop 3 projects this year, actually, but this is just the first one, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's so much work. I just been working, like,
are you
working.
One of those people that goes in the studio and knocks out
a bunch
of songs?
Oh, yeah, knock out a bunch of records. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, because I love music. Like, I really love music. Before I even got into it, being an artist, you understand? I love music
You're
in every genre. So I just... this is what I do. You could play any beat and we just go at it. We just go at it. The thoughts just, you know, so when I'm in the studio, I'm just going, you know, I don't really travel with 30 people to the studio. It's just me because that's my job. You understand? When I go there, it's time to work. I don't need no distractions. You understand? Yeah. Like, you're going to write a hook for me anyway. So I just, you know, me, I just lock in, you know, so I got a lot of work done, you know, talking about.
Well, I can't wait to hear it.
Yeah, yeah.
Now you've convinced, you've got me excited.
Definitely, man.
Now I'm excited.
Nah, most definitely.
So I guess after album drops, we'll do this again.
And we definitely gonna do this again. Situation. Yeah, exactly. That's what I want. I want the assessment because I know it's just gonna be so real. This project is really good. Like I'm standing on it, behind it, under it. This project is very good. It's good. It's
don't
good.
Don't you believe it? I believe
I'm excited, man.
You know,
I'm excited.
Everybody says that,
you know,
though.
Yeah, I know. But
I, for some reason, I believe you.
Yeah, man. I just, the time, man. The time was put in, man. And, you know, we chose, you know, 15 songs out of 100. You know what I'm saying? Like, it wasn't more or less like we had to, like, oh, we only got 20 songs. And I was like, 100. So all I do is write and make music. You understand? And,
yeah.
And, oh, man, I promise you, man.
Oh,
just get
you.
Ready for this project. PH, man.
Good
I'm excited.
For you, baby. I'm looking forward
yeah,
to
definitely.
It. So you said the dates that could be are?
Yeah, 6th or 13th.
6th or 13th.
Yeah. Right
so
now, we're
month.
Finalizing everything. By Friday, we'll know whether it's the 6th or the 13th, you know?
All right.
Right now, you know, projects, you don't need much time to push anymore. You don't want to be 30-day countdown. Anyway. That doesn't work no more. 7-day countdown and put it out, you know?
Or a 30-minute countdown.
Yeah, 30-minute countdown. Yes, exactly, exactly.
Here you go. Who bid Beyonce?
I don't know.
I don't know why there's a thing that says who bit Beyonce. Somebody bit Beyonce in the face.
No way. What?
You don't know the story. I don't know why. Sorry. I just got distracted because I looked at it.
Do you want it?
Let me see. I think there's a packet under here for you. This was the double. Oh, no. This was your copy of the XXL listings. No, somebody bit Beyonce.
No, why?
I don't know. Tiffany Haddish reported this story that she was at a party. Some lady, an actress, bit Beyonce. And Tiffany says she was going to fight. She wanted to fight the lady. And Beyonce was like, no, just chill or whatever.
Tiffany who?
Tiffany Haddish, the comedian.
Oh, yeah. What?
Tiffany Haddish told this story to GQ. So today it came out. And they said, and so now everybody, but she didn't say who it was, who the actress was. So now it's trending on the internet.
Who bit Beyonce?
Who bit Beyonce?
Nah, that's wild. And nobody knows? Beyonce didn't talk about it?
I thought Phresher, maybe you knew.
No, I don't know. I don't have a relationship like with Beyonce or Jay, so I don't really know.
Nor
Blue, so we're done. Nor Blue, we're done. Or maybe Solange.
What type of animal?
Yeah, you don't bite Beyonce.
You don't bite anybody.
No, but you don't bite Beyonce.
Definitely don't bite Beyonce.
Mike wouldn't even bite Beyonce.
No.
Tyson, we talk about.
Jay probably barely bites Beyonce.
Nah, Jay probably bites. No, Neville. He never on her. You know, Jay Neville on her. Jay Neville on her. Jay from Brooklyn.
As he should.
Jay from Brooklyn. You know,
you
Brooklyn,
right.
We Neville. We Neville.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Jay from Brooklyn, we never lose, man. So,
all right, so you partially solved the mystery,
Phresher.
Thank you for that.
Jay bit Beyonce. There we go. Okay,
there
got you.
Go. Solved by Phresher.
Exactly,
today.
There we go. Huh?
Amazing. Well, it was so good to meet you again.
Nah, definitely,
I know
yeah.
we met briefly.
Yeah,
out
we
in the
never
streets,
really met. I always just wanted to say, Angie, you're a legend, and I'm so happy to be in your presence. I never really had the chance to say that. It's always
thanks,
you
man.
Look at me like, hey, this is. We met about 2 or 3 times, and every time it was like, I'm like, damn, she still don't know who I am.
I'm
like,
so
this is
sorry.
Not good.
But you know why? Because I probably meet you in cases where, I think when we met, it was like in the stairwell, I'm leaving
yeah,
the
yeah,
event,
look,
you're
let me
on
tell you
your
when
way
we
in,
met.
You
let me
got
tell you
40
when we met.
People around you.
I'm going to tell you when we met. And this is why I didn't
was
take offense.
Was there 40 people around
yes,
you?
Yes, no.
Of course.
Thousands of people around. We
okay.
met at.
So I'm trying to make a beeline.
Exactly.
That's
we met at in L.A. We did the right before the award. No, what you call it? The radio room. So you already know you're on fire in there. You're stopping doing 30 pitches. And I got a falling line between the 30. Like,
so
hi, Angie.
Sorry.
And I already know I was getting that work. It's cool. I said, I can't wait to see her today. Where it's just me and her. And I can say, Angie, I love you. You're a legend. Hug. And there we go. You know, we did it. So
but now I will,
yeah.
I will
so
never
now,
do
from
that.
Now, you'll remember me. There we go.
Stop.
There we go. Got you. There
I
we go.
Acknowledge,
yeah. Hey,
I will
Fresh. That's all I want.
Right,
hey, Angie. Hey, Fresh.
That's
and boom. And I'm good.
And we're good.
It was
all
always
right,
like, weird guy.
I know. No.
You know, cool.
But that's your interpretation.
Nah,
definitely
cool.
not
it's
what
cool.
I was thinking.
It's cool though.
We're okay though.
Yeah, we're good.
All right, good. I'm glad.
We're good.
I'm looking forward to the album, baby.
Definitely, man.
Congrats on everything. And I hope you make the freshman cover too. Just
shout out to Double XL.
It would be nice.
Shout out to Double XL.
Because it would be nice. It's cool. Way.
Ali, exactly. All I love Double XL either way.
Love one time for Phresher.
Thanks
please.
So much, man. Appreciate you, Angie.